I know I haven't slept at all. Obviously, I've been uploading and editing videos and stuff like that for you guys like I usually do. So it looks like we have about 6 inches of snow. Oh, the snow plow came by. You can see because I have no way out of here unless I plow through it like this. Yee-hoo! Oh, yeah. Gotta love it. So we're going to be holding the camera while we're doing this drive. Because this camera uploads the videos way faster than the other cameras do. And it's very unfortunate that we have to hold the camera in this weather. But it's early enough where there's really no one on the road still. That was a plow. Alright, so here we go. It says 38 degrees, but that's so wrong. I mean, it might actually be something like that. So we're gonna do the whole valley tour, you guys. You know what would have been cool if I brought my new gimbal and used the gimbal to hold the gimbal to make it just as much smoother video, but it's all good. As long as you guys enjoy it, I'm happy. I better enjoy these smokes. I'm just quitting pretty soon here. So we're going to be driving to the part of town that gets the least amount of snow. This is what I've coined as the Big Bear Snow Rule. But yeah, this is about when a lot of you are going to be waking up and getting breakfast and, you know, getting in the shower and stuff like that. Dropping a deuce, getting ready for the day. Yeah. If you guys like, I'm not going to mention it a whole lot more, I promise. But if you guys like... or enjoy seeing like beautiful 5-star hotels or just really nice hotels and stuff like that, I have another YouTube channel that I've created where I'm doing stuff like that and staying in these nicer places because I didn't think I would be able to ever. So I'm just trying to give hope to a lot of people and inspiration and tell my story about all my drug use and alcohol and how I've overcome and been able to do so much for my mom and dad now, which, like, they're the people I used to take from. It's just unbelievable. So it's called Luxury Hotel and Resort Travel. I'd be stoked if you guys subscribe. I'll post a link. But yeah, that'd be super cool. You guys rock, man. Anyway, we are going to be driving through here to Baldwin Lake. If we had... Well, we could probably drive up to Onyx Summit also. That would be such a long video, you guys. Oh my god. Ah, what the hell, huh? I mean, we don't have really nothing more to do. Except sleep. I mean, we can sleep when we're dead, right? Man, people are charging. It's not just me. They're charging, man. Look at the skies. It's clear skies up here. Kind of. On this side of town, but it does look like Baldwin's a little bit socked in. It's amazing, at this time of day, the camera, you can see a lot better in the distance than you can with your own eyes. It's really cool. These iPhone cameras are spectacular. Holy moly. I spent a fortune on like 5 GoPro Hero 8s for our channel, and it's not... Like, I like them, but I'm not too impressed with them. If they had this quality camera, it'd be awesome. This camera in here is amazing. Or my drone camera. It's a Hasselblad camera. It's amazing. Yeah, I think we'll drive up to Onyx Summit. Why not? I hope this video posts before everyone wakes up. Jeez. But this would be the best time to do it. So when you guys wake up at like 8 or 9, the late wakers. And then the really late wakers like me at like 11 at noon. from Onyx Summit, we're gonna drive through Baldwin. This is the complete valley tour we're doing right now, guys. This is gonna be awesome. It's gonna be a super long video if we make it, because I need to take these turns a little more safe. But you guys know it's your boy. It's your boy. So over by Onyx, it's probably gonna be snowing. At Onyx Summit, it's probably gonna be snowing. It's probably gonna be about 20 degrees, or close to 20. Summit, you guys, for those of you who don't know, that's where Highway 38 goes through. So when you're taking Highway 38 up the backs, or the, it's still the front, but it's like the back side of the front. It's the long way up, but I think it's the safest way up. Even though you hit a higher elevation and you have the potential to hit more snow at points, it's still safer in my eyes. Remember, it said 38 degrees, now look at it, 27. Typically doesn't get as much snow, but the further you go that direction to the left over in Baldwin, significantly less. But you can see there's less snow over here than there is by my house, but it's still a good amount of snow, a few inches. I said, this is one way that people come into town. They take this route. Which, this is the route that I always suggest my mom to take, especially in the summertime, though. Because, yeah, it's about 6 or 7 miles further, longer, but it's safer. There's not as many cliffs to fall off. It's just a safer journey. Plus, the chain checkpoint guy is going to be here. I'm going to have to make up some story. I totally forgot about him. He may be our demise when it comes to one over here, all the way up to Onyx Summit, but we'll see. You'll be able to see the Big Bear snow rule in effect. You'll see that my side of town's still getting a bunch of snow, and this side of town, there's nothing happening. Look at this, hardly any snow here. Thank you. screw up and go down there, do you? Nope. It's not that bad of a fall right there, but you still wouldn't want to do it. Look at the storminess out there. That's the part of the storm that got pushed south of the mountain range. So as we climb, it is going to get colder, and the roads are going to get more treacherous because it's going to be more icy. A deeper freeze. Get up to Onyx Summit, we're gonna hit the other side of the mountain range, and we're gonna get some clouds. Probably. At least I thought we would. Yeah, there's a few clouds right there. They wanna come over right there. So yeah guys, this is Highway 38. We're approaching Onyx Summit right now. We're gonna turn around at the summit and come back down. We're not gonna have any traffic ahead of us because we're the only car. So, coming up to the Onyx Summit, sign 8,443 feet.
side, but it's alright. Maybe someone ran it over. That's pretty cool.
Right there.
Someone must have knocked it down. Anyway, we're heading back into the valley. The valley of Big Bear. Bear Valley. Then we're going to drive through Baldwin so you guys can check out Baldwin. Then we're going to drive all the way back around through Fonskin. Then back home, and then I'm going to sleep for like an hour or two. So forgive me if I don't get back to the comments right away. Trust me, I want to, especially in this weather. I need you guys to be safe. At the same time, if I don't get any sleep, I'm not going to be worth anything. Wow. Look at how pretty it is. All the snow-covered trees. Everything looks so beautiful. It's such a beautiful sight. Wow. So the storms, this second part of the storm's blowing in like crazy. When we came up here, it was clear skies. Look what's happening now. It happened so fast, you guys. It's amazing. It was clear right there. It was completely clear when we just drove up. And 10 minutes later, it's completely socked in with clouds and it's snowing again. Snow on the other side of town. I want you guys to really pay attention, the ones who are still watching. Pay attention when we drive through the other side of Baldwin Lake, how little snow they have. And then pay attention to when we get to the Big Bear Dam, how much snow they have. It's pretty incredible. Oh my gosh, the first car I've seen. In the car though, because I like to drive faster on these roads, but now I have to slow down. Bummer. Wow, that's beautiful right there. Just watch the road, but that's just too great. Okay. Everyone thinks I have my brights on, and it gets frustrating. It's probably because my truck, my Subaru is lifted. I need to tilt the lights down a little bit. just really focusing, guys. Sorry. Really in focus. Just till we get out done with these last couple little turns, and then we can kind of not pay as much attention to the road. Obviously, I'm paying full attention to the road, you guys. You know what I mean. And when other people start coming out onto the road, be assured that I'm not going to be driving faster or anything like that. And then when we get to the Big Bear Dam, you guys are going to get the perspective of driving into town from that direction on Highway 18 on the front. Highway 330 to Highway 18, or just Waterman Canyon to Highway 18 all the way up. And you'll also see the entrance up to the mountain from the backside of Highway 18. So I'll point it all out to you guys. You'll get to see it all. You just saw... You're on the entrance from Highway 38 into Big Bear right now. Side of town has at least twice this much, guarantee you. Once we get over to the Big Bear Dam, you'll see. But the first stop is Baldwin. Oh my gosh. I have an idea. I can kind of make this turn, get out of here. Now watch, he's like waiting for me right up here. That'd be so funny. I really don't think he like actually turned around. I think he just hit his brake. Like, he went a long way before his brake lights turned on. I'm just trying to be a little extra dramatic, but just in case anyone thinks, oh my gosh, he's outrunning a cop. I'm really not. But there were cars gaining on me, but there were three cars behind me and they were like gaining on me. So that was kind of weird. That was kind of weird. But anyway, we're entering Baldwin now. This part of Baldwin seems like they have a decent amount of snow. Unreal, guys. Unreal. As you can see, it's Baldwin. Clear skies. And when we get to the other side of town, you'll see there's a lot of clouds on the other side of town and a lot of weather. We'll see soon enough. Big old sound, that's so cool. I mean, for this side of Baldwin, a decent amount of snow. Little surprised. But when we get to the other side, and then when we get to the Big Bear Dam, you'll be able to notice a huge difference though. So if there's this much snow here, there must be a bunch over at the dam. I'm really looking forward to that. 6:30, 9. Saw a couple donkeys here earlier in one of the videos. It was the video where I saw a fireball flying across the sky. It was insane.
such a beautiful prairie. Just wide open and beautiful. It's just insanely beautiful over here. It's a beautiful retreat area, guys, right here. To get away from town and just be in a quiet area. Snow out here the further we go. I mean, they didn't even really have to plow out here, but they did. Now watch me get stuck out here. And that side of town, that's where I live. Look at how dark it is over there, but it's clear right here, and it's dark over there. I live in the dark area. This is a lot because it's a lot for Baldwin on this, like, in this area. However, when there's this much over here, I'm really excited to see what's on the other side of town. Because we've been gone for a while. Hey, aren't you guys cold? Just getting snowed on.
Just like, keep driving. Keep driving. Nothing to see here. Nothing to see here.
There's a fence there. There's a fence there. And a pole. Oh, wow. We just lost a little bit. I mean, I knew I was going to lose it. That's why I tugged the wheel a little bit. Because I was stuck in a certain position. But regain control quickly. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Okay, so this is the least snowiest part of town of it. And that's the snowiest part way over there where the dark clouds are. That's where we're headed. It's like 5 inches over here. I can't believe it. 4 or 5 inches. At least. Or maybe, you know what, maybe not that much. I've seen the piles from the snow plows, but now I'm looking at the houses and the side of the road where the snow plows don't touch, and it looks like, well, shoot, but look at the tracks in the road. It looks deep, maybe 4 inches over here. So this is where you come in from Highway 18 on the backside, right here. See that? And then you want to go to Big Bear Lake this direction. And that's what we're doing. Now we're on Highway 18. Wow, you guys are getting a tour right now. The full-on tour ski. I'm driving like on that side of the road, into the turns, but I can see way up here. So there's Baldwin. Look, there's clear skies over Baldwin, and the clouds just push and just dissipate right there. It's insane, you guys. Every single snowstorm, and when the strongest pushes of the storm come through, then they get to Baldwin, and then they dissipate before they hit the desert. Lots of times, it's pretty interesting. I mean, just look at how cool that is, though. All right, we got a little hairy turn here, but we'll be good. I'm so glad no one's in the room right now. It makes our life so much easier. It makes this video a little bit shorter than it would be. Actually, I guarantee you a lot bit shorter than it would be. But look at how dark the clouds are out there. Look at that. Oh my gosh. Look at that sunrise. Wow. So cool, man. So pretty. And as I said, Baldwin, this whole area right here is just so gorgeous, man. It's just amazing. So quiet. So look, it's clear skies here, and once we come around this corner up here, it's going to be nothing but clouds and snow coming down. And dark clouds in that. And we're taking this all the way to the dam, guys. All the way to the Jean-Claude Van Damme. Yeah, buddy. Right here, these are little ditches, you guys. It looks like it's flat and the snow covers it. Be very careful. These are ditches. They're not too deep, but they're deep enough to give you a really bad day. That's beautiful. We're driving into that in just a moment. I saved like the snowiest part of the drive for last. That guy was driving in my lane. Can you believe it? Usually I'm driving in their lane, but I'm actually like, I don't do it on blind turns like this one up here. But that guy didn't care. So we basically gave each other a shave. A nice close shave. over here. Dark skies and darker skies. So beautiful. See how I handled that? I was pretty damn good.
I'm getting better. I'm getting better.
How great my vehicle is for this weather. Look at this guy. He's like some off-roading rescue guy. And he's hardly going 20 miles an hour. Hell, I should start rescuing people because I'll get there fast in this type of weather. You know that. I'd be a good 911 driver or like ambulance driver in this type of weather, I'll tell you that. If he doesn't turn left at Stanfield, I'm going to have to pass him. Usually by now people pull over to let you by. But yeah, it's a winter wonderland out here, guys. It's just so absolutely remarkably beautiful. Technically in Fonskin. I didn't realize that. It's this early. But the town's up here. It's a good lake views right here. And on the other side. Weather, my goodness. Good for that, man.
good breakfast place up here to the right. Degrees, starting to snow again as we get back to the snowiest part of town. You can tell there's a lot more snow over here. It looks like we have about 7 inches of snow over here. Maybe not quite that much, maybe 6 inches. Thank you.
am now. You guys can see how much snow is over here compared to Baldwin, where they've shoveled, or old plow. Take a look, scroll back into the other part of the video. This light never changes when there's snow for some reason. So much more snow over here. I mean, it's not that much, it's like 6 inches, but compared to the other side of town. But then again, the other side of town, it looked like they had a decent amount, but this is definitely a lot more. bay, you can hardly even see the bay. It's snowing so good. And there's trees blocking it. There's part of it. Best ones though, the ones where no one looks like they're hurt. those are more of like condos. So we're driving through the village right now, you guys. I want you guys to get a good look at the village. It's such a winter wonderland. I love it so much. It's a little bumpy, guys. Back on Big Bear Boulevard. Getting some snow. Here's that Caltrans guy who we were behind earlier. To Ren. Watch this. Woohoo! We just broke right through that wall. We'll turn on the Brownie Lane. Wow, this is awesome, guys. There's so much snow over here. Like 7:25 right now.